Before the 2020 NFL season, one of the hottest topics was about how good Arizona was going to be. Kyler Murray was supposed to be an MVP candidate in year two alongside DeAndre Hopkins. Cliff Kingsbury was supposed to be a coaching genius. Instead, the Cardinals went 8-8 and missed the playoffs, which raises the question, are the Arizona Cardinals actually good? It's wild to think that just two seasons ago, the Cardinals went 3-13 behind Josh Rosen at quarterback. Things clearly didn't go how Arizona wanted, and it decided to hire a new head coach, Cliff Kingsbury. With that came the first overall pick at the 2019 NFL Draft, which the Cardinals used on Kyler Murray. Since then, the Cardinals have only won 13 of 32 games and missed the playoffs twice. Now, Cliff Kingsbury is on the hot seat after not being able to succeed with a talented roster that had acquired DeAndre Hopkins last offseason in an attempt to build around Kyler Murray. So, we're going to take a deep dive to see if we can figure out if the Cardinals are actually good. I don't think it's exactly fair to critique a coach's first year with a team, especially when it's their first year in the NFL with a rookie quarterback. The Cardinals weren't all of a sudden good in 2019. They were still really bad, going 5-10-1 and finishing last in the NFC West. That was a 2-win increase from the season before, and it did have some good moments. They weren't supposed to be good, but once Kingsbury and Murray got their footing in the league, people expected a huge jump forward, and the media were putting them up in the ranks of some of the best teams in the league, but they weren't. On paper, the Cardinals were good to start the season. They started off 5-2 and looked pretty good going into their bye week, but this is what you would call fool's gold. Only one of those teams in the 7-game span went over 500 on the year. Going up against better teams in the second half of the season, the Cardinals only managed to win 3 games, against the miserable Giants and Eagles, and against the Bills with the iconic Hail Mary when Kyler found Hopkins on a Hail Mary last second. Arizona finished 8-8, and thanks to the new 7-team playoff format, they had a chance to make the postseason as late as Week 17, where it lost to the Rams, who ended up starting backup John Wolford. But to be fair, Murray was nursing a leg injury at the time. With that, it leaves Cliff Kingsbury at 13-18-1 as a head coach in the NFL. There are a lot of questions on Kingsbury, and if the Cardinals can't find a way to win in 2021, he may be out of a job. He has been consistently touted as a genius, but we haven't seen it at all yet. All that talent on the roster, and he hasn't had a winning season. The interesting thing about that is he really didn't have a ton of success in college either. His one head coach gig was at Texas Tech, and because of that, he's gotten a lot of the credit for Patrick Mahomes having success. But reality is that he was just 35-40 as a head coach. There are still a lot of questions about Kingsbury, and at least for the expectations that came with him, he's undoubtedly failed so far. So what about Kyler Murray? He's a tougher case to actually study. Murray came into the league with huge expectations, as any number one overall pick is gonna have, but perhaps even more due to the Cardinals getting rid of Josh Rosen after a single season to take him. The stats can be deceiving to an extent with Murray. In terms of passing in 2020, his stats were almost identical to two different quarterbacks, both which had a bad year according to media, that being Matt Ryan and Matthew Stafford. One is said to be washed, and the other one just got traded away. The good news is that Murray does bring another part of his game by using his legs. He had the second most rushing yards by a quarterback behind Lamar Jackson in 2020, while also posting similar passing stats. It's definitely fair to say that Kyler Murray hasn't actually lived up to his expectations, but honestly, I think that's just because the bar was set way too high. Going into year two, he was touted as going to win the MVP potentially. That wasn't fair to Murray to expect a Lamar Jackson type year two jump, but maybe we see a Josh Allen type of progression. Allen was like really bad as a rookie, but he improved a ton in his second season before making a huge jump in 2020, and maybe Murray ends up on that same path. Murray is nowhere close to where he was initially expected to be by now, but if you watch him play, there shouldn't be many worries. He's extremely talented, and he has everything you want out of your star quarterback in today's game: the ability to use his legs and a good arm. He may need some time to figure things out, but if he can rely on the rest of his offensive pieces around him and his teammates on the other side of the field, the Cardinals could contend for sure. The Cardinals' defense was middle of the pack in 2020, and according to most outlets, it's expected to be there again despite the signing of J.J. Watt. Watt is now teamed up with Chandler Jones to form a pretty impressive duo, but that doesn't solve all of the defensive problems, especially with Patrick Peterson and Dre Kirkpatrick leaving gaping holes in the secondary. There is some hope, though. If Isaiah Simmons can make a huge jump and first-round rookie Zaven Collins can actually come in and make an impact, the defense may end up being a lot better than anticipated. There needs to be some kind of caveat here for the Cardinals, and that's this. You can't expect a first-year head coach and a rookie quarterback to be able to just come out and succeed. They need time. And for last year, well, it's safe to say it wasn't exactly a normal season with COVID and all. Murray could have really used that time in training camp to improve ahead of the year, but he didn't have it. Things haven't exactly fallen their way, and honestly, having to play the teams in the NFC West doesn't exactly help their case. The 49ers literally made a Super Bowl 2 seasons ago, the Rams made one 3 seasons ago, and the Seahawks have one of the best quarterbacks in the league in Russell Wilson. I'm willing to bet you could drop the Cardinals in both divisions, and they're fighting for the division crown. So, what's the actual verdict on the Cardinals? Are they actually good? Well, the answer needs to be broken up into two parts. They obviously weren't good when Kyler Murray was a rookie, but even last year, they weren't good. Even at 8-8, they only beat 2 teams over .500. One came in overtime against the Seahawks, and the other one on a fluke Hail Mary against the Bills. That's not exactly something to hang your hat on. So last year, no, they weren't good. But Arizona could make a giant leap in 2021. It's definitely possible, which leaves the answer still up in the air of whether or not they're good. Based on the last 2 years, the Cardinals are not good. But the NFL is a weird game of progressions and improvements over time. Arizona has a significantly better roster now than it did 2 years ago after building through the draft, free agency, and trades. And with that, Kyler Murray has improved since coming into the league as well. The Cardinals are slowly building a contender, but it's just a matter of time of when it starts playing like it. The Cardinals are probably going to be one of the top stories to watch in 2021. A young, talented quarterback, a top wide receiver in the league, a dominant pass rush duo, and of course, a head coach on the hot seat. If Cliff Kingsbury can't put it together this season with that talent on the roster, the Cardinals are going to be searching for a new head coach next offseason. As of now, the Cardinals haven't actually been good, but boy, do they have the potential to be. Hey, so we're trying to hit 100,000 subscribers before the preseason starts in August, so click right here to subscribe to the channel. And if you don't want to, you already do because you're awesome. Go ahead and click right here and watch another video. Peace.